show you guys some DIY easy group costumes. So all these costumes can be either worn individually or with a group of friends. Not only are these like super easy to make, but they also cost a minimal amount of money and they're super cute too. So if you end up liking this video, make sure to give it a big old thumbs up as well as subscribe to my channel down below. I post new videos every single Saturday. And without further ado, let's get on to the video. So the first group costume idea I have for you guys is basically all you and your friends can dress up as cereal box characters. So starting off with the Honey Nut Cheerios, the B character, this one is super easy to make. All you're gonna need is a yellow t-shirt and then just mask that off into stripes with some masking tape like this. And then just take some black fabric paint. You could also use like a fabric pen. And then just go ahead and paint your shirt black like this. I think the best way to get like a clean line when you're using masking tape and paint is to kind of dab it on like this and do it in a way where the brush is perpendicular to the way the tape is going. And then as you can see in the last line here, I ran out of paint, so I had to use a black fabric marker. That worked well too, it just took a little bit longer. But anyway, once that was done, I just proceeded to take the tape off of the shirt and I was left with some super nice clean black and yellow lines. So now moving on to the headpiece of the costume, I started off with a black headband and some yellow and black pipe cleaners, and then I just took two of those and wrapped them around the top of the headband like this to secure them, and then I just twisted both of the pipe cleaners around each other like this to give it kind of a swirled look. And of course I did that again to two more pipe cleaners right next to the first pair, and once I twisted them up to a good length, I cut off the excess. To finish it off, I just took two small yellow pom-poms and I placed them in between the two pipe cleaners and then wrapped them around the pom-pom like this to secure it in place. And of course, I did that for both sides. And that is basically how you make a bee antennae headband. So now moving on to the next serial character costume, we have the Trix Bunny. So this costume pretty much only requires you have bunny ears. So to make these, first start out with a sheet of white felt and then fold it like this hamburger style. And then just take a pencil, a pen, or a marker, and just mark out the shape you want your ears to be. As you can see, mine were very uneven, so I had to kind of compensate for that when I was cutting them out. Once those are done being cut out, just unfold them so they are left looking like this. And then just take some white pipe cleaners or wire, as well as a white headband. And then just take the ears and put them around the headband like this. And then cut a piece of wire or pipe cleaner so they fit inside the ear. Put a little bit of hot glue or regular glue around the pipe cleaner. And then fold the ear up so both sides meet and you have the pipe cleaner inside the ear basically. And then of course you're going to want to do that for both ears so you have two ears right next to each other. The Trix Bunny actually doesn't have that pink part inside of its ear, so after you're done doing that, you are done making your very own bunny ears. So now moving on to the last cereal costume, we have the Lucky Charms Leprechaun. So for this one, you're going to want to start out by tracing a Peter Pan collar shape onto the back of some white adhesive felt. It should basically look like this, and then just cut it out. And since this is adhesive felt, all you have to do is peel off the back and then stick it on your shirt around the collar area like this. Or if you happen to use regular felt, just apply some glue on the back and stick it down. Next, just take some thick gold ribbon like this. Cut that to a length you want and then cut the top so it fits in between the collar in the middle like this. And then just apply some more glue on the bottom of it so it sticks to the bottom and top of the shirt. And that is how you make a super snazzy leprechaun shirt. So here's what all the finished costumes look like. So for the leprechaun costume, I paired it with a black belt and then I carried around the Lucky Charms cereal box. For the bee costume, I just wore some black leggings as well as carried around the Honey Nut Cheerios box. And for the bunny costume, I just wore some white clothes with my bunny ears as well as carried around the Trix cereal box. Also, all these costumes were incredibly easy to make and pretty much everyone cost me under $15, so very cheap as well. Plus, you get an excuse to carry around a box of sugary cereal all day, which is not a bad thing, especially on Halloween. It's also a great way to have the excuse to dress up as something basic like a bee or a bunny, because if you carry around a cereal box with it, it seems really creative and fun. This next next group costume idea is basically all you and your friends can dress up as high school yearbook superlatives. So essentially, you just carry around a yearbook photo cut out like this, and at the bottom it says most likely to blank, and then also wear basic high school stereotype outfits like a cheerleader, a prom queen, a nerd, or like a gothic person. So to make the yearbook photo cutout, start off with a big white piece of cardstock paper, and then trace around the border so you have kind of like a Polaroid shape like this, so you have a bigger space at the bottom than you do at the top. And then just cut along those same lines with a box cutter or an X-Acto knife to cut out the middle. So now moving on to the superlative part, one of the things I decided to write was most likely to steal your man, because I thought that one of the popular girl stereotype. I also wrote most likely to scare a freshman, because that kind of went with the gothic stereotype. And then on the last one, I wrote most likely to be your boss in 10 years, because that kind of went with the nerd stereotype. So as for the actual costumes, for the most likely to steal your man superlative, I wore a prom queen costume, which just consisted of a pretty dress, a prom queen sash I got on Amazon for like $6, and a tiara, as well as the yearbook photo cutout. And for the most likely to be your boss in 10 years superlative, I wore a nerd costume, which consisted of a pleated skirt, a button-up shirt, and a sweater tied around my waist, as well as some glasses and braids, and I just thought that was very fitting for the boss costume. And then last but not least, to go with the most likely to scare freshman costume, I decided to dress up as a gothic girl. So I thought that would go very well with this superlative. So I just wore some dark lipstick and black clothes and combat boots, and it worked pretty well. And the last group costume idea is Essie nail polishes. So all you and your friends can dress up as different colored nail polishes, basically. So to make this costume, start out with some adhesive white felt, and then just trace the Essie logo onto the felt, which is basically just spelling out the word Essie in this specific kind of block letter font. So I just drew that on with some pencil, and then I cut it out with scissors, which was a little bit hard and a bit time consuming, but it was totally worth it, and definitely easier than doing it with like paint or iron-ons, I think. So in the end, I think it was the best way to do it. Next, just lay out a plain colored t-shirt, and then remove the backings of the words, and then place them on the shirt like this so they are spelling it upwards. That's how they are spelled on the bottle. I don't know why, but that's how they are, so I decided to do it the same way on the shirt. So once that's done, you're going to want to make the headpiece. So all you're going to need for that is just a piece of cardstock paper. Roll that up into like a cylinder shape and then staple it shut. And then just hole punch two holes in either side of the bottom of the cylinder thing. Next, just take a thin white headband and then kind of thread it through the holes on the cylinder like this. And then to finish it off, just kind of push it towards the center of the headband, and you have a cool nail polish top headpiece. A fun way to incorporate this into the group costume is that basically all you and your friends can be different colored nail polishes. So just wear a different colored t-shirts, and then everything the rest about the costume can be the same, like the lettering and the headpiece, and it's really cute.
If you are not already, make sure you are subscribed to my channel down below. I post new videos every single Saturday. I also have an Instagram, a Twitter, a Snapchat, and a YouNow. So make sure you guys are following me in all of those. I will have all of them linked down below, as well as a few on the screen right now. And yeah, I will see you guys next Saturday with a new video. Bye!